is how consumers feel when one business monopolizes an entire industry.
What you got?
This is Andrew Carnegie, one of America's greatest monopolists of the late 19th century. Let's go back to when he was just a young bobbin boy. Carnegie had his start when his boss at the textile factory paid him in a share of the business. He invested the share and was on his way to a major fortune in 1848, at the ripe age of 13.
With the fortune he amassed, Carnegie began to dominate the steel industry by using vertical and horizontal integration, buying out competitors and the factors of production. His monopoly on steel allowed him to dictate prices, determine how much steel to produce, and the quality of the steel. This made for an unfair advantage over consumers and the industries that relied on steel.
I can't believe this just happened. I just got bought out now and I have no sources of income. How am I supposed to affect prices and supply if I don't exist in the economy?
Luckily for us, Andrew Carnegie was very generous with his wealth and donated much of it to the arts and other public services.
Man, I don't regret this decision at all. See, if I could go in like this, I'd be the richest man in the world.
Monopolies do not benefit anyone but the businesses who profit from them. Competitors are eliminated, leaving consumers vulnerable to the price, quality, and quantity dictation to the monopolizing company.
Oh, sorry.
This is why the only solution to our problems is communism.
Money, 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 money.